Today is the first day of school for this 31st grader, and what better way to begin the school year than with the Take the Lake battle in volleyball. Matamidi and White Bear Lake. High school girls volleyball, and it's right here on SCC Sports. And it's time to introduce that surfboard trophy that will be up for grabs. Both teams have laid claim to it. Now, that is not me. I am Mike Peden, but I do not resemble that surfboard. I am on the other side. So don't worry. Nothing weird is happening to my body or to your picture. But the winner of this game will get to take that surfboard with them. Will it be at White Bear Lake or Matamidi? We'll find out in due time. Matamidi and White Bear Lake both fielding younger squads with not much experience. Matamidi reaching state last year in Class 3A, but only two starters from that team are back, and a lot of sophomores. Matamidi, that learning curve was evident as we take a look at our profiles, the tail of the tape, if you will. White Bear Lake, they've won both their home games so far, and they also have two starters from last year's team in Kylie Gustafson and Kaylee Giske. Matamidi, first game against an opponent above 500. Their two starters from last year's state tournament squad, Sylvie Greitzer and Kylie Mulvey. Matamidi picking up their first win of the season in their last game, pulling off a reverse sweep over Highland Park last Thursday. As we take a look at the White Bear Lake coaching staff, White Bear Lake and Mackenzie Leverty in her second season. White Bear Lake finished a game under 500, a place last in the Suburban East. We'll see what happens this time around. The Suburban East going through some makeovers. And there's our new head coach for Matamidi. She was part of the group last year coaching the freshman team, Tia Schlund. That's actually Tia to the right. That's the assistant, Danny. There's Tia, who's wearing the Matamidi colors. Volleyball fans from long ago may remember when she wore similar colors at Concordia St. Paul. She helped them reach the NCAA Division II tournament for the first two times in school history and placed second in 2003, of course, Concordia St. Paul, collecting a whole boatload of trophies since then, setting the standard in Division II women's volleyball. Matamidi will wear the white kits. White Bear Lake will wear the black. And as you know, point on every play, you play up to 25 until the fifth set, if needed, and you got to win by two. And with a point on every play, that places an emphasis on limiting your mistakes. The two teams have split the series since the Take the Lake trophy was offered in this rivalry. These two schools meet in every sport outside of football as they occupy both sides of White Bear Lake. White Bear Lake on the west side, Matamidi on the right side. As we take a look at White Bear Lake and their score by set, the third set has been very kind to them in the early going, and that fifth set, they don't have too many of those yet. But White Bear Lake will serve to begin this one, and we're underway. Matamidi going up the left side. White Bear Lake makes the up. Now they attack from the left side. Shot deflected. But the up goes out of bounds. Kylie Gustafson making the play there. White Bear Lake won the first Take the Lake battle. Matamidi emerged victorious last year. Coincidentally, Matamidi stands for White Bear Lake in Dakota, or something to that effect. Gustafson's shot doesn't find the mark this time. That will go down as a hitting error. And a point awarded to Matamidi. Sahar Ramali for the Zephyrs. White Bear Lake couldn't play that serve aggressively. A good chance for Madam Edai as they go to the right side and land a point. Number 13, Kylie Mulvey. It's early and it's warm. Really warm. We'll talk about that in a moment. Right now, let's talk about that block up front. Number 21, Bella Thompson, one of the players involved there. And the stats that I'm keeping track of are unofficial, but they do help paint a picture. Temperatures got to around 90 today. It's also muggy, making for extremely warm conditions here and what will be the last season for White Bear Lake in this gym. But Kylie Gustafson is hoping to make more than one last stand in this game. Next year, if I remember correctly, every team, everyone will make the move over to the North Campus as the North Campus undergoing an extensive upgrade. All brand new facilities, and the South Campus will become a middle school. And speaking of middle, White Bear Lake scores from the middle. That's number 12, Ella Stather. Some of the teams, as I understand it, have already made the move to the North Campus. But everyone will make the jump next year. Exciting times for the students who will be sticking around. Hitting error on Gustafson. That's her second. And we're still even at three in the early going. White Bear Lake 2-1, Madam Edai 1-2. Fine serve by the Zephyrs. Luisa Tarnowski delivers our first ace. Tarnowski, the all-around presence for the Zephyrs. She can play outside, right side, and middle blocker. A strong front row component. Zephyrs come up from the right. White Bear Lake gets the up. The dig was a little high. White Bear Lake gets another chance. Tarnowski with the up. Madam Edai tried to set things up on that near left corner. But the pass was offline. And Bella Thompson couldn't do anything with it. White Bear Lake scoring there. 5-4 the score. Low serve from Gustafson. And Madam Edai jammed. Another low serve from Gustafson, and that's back-to-back points. As Madam Edai was confounded once again. Tarnowski's style, getting the job done. That's 3 points in a row. She nets an ace there. She has induced two misfires and now an ace. White Bear Lake takes a 7-5 lead. Now Madam Edai gets a serve, or I should say the up down, but not the attack. So a hitting error will be charged to Maddie Pearson. And this could be a key stretch. There's still a long way to go, but getting those rallies with someone on serve can go a long way. Our first setter dump of the evening, White Bear Lake reads it. Tarnowski from the back row. Madam Edai gets another chance. Ramali attacking from the back row there. White Bear Lake with the off-speed lob. Madam Edai able to save it. from the middle, the Bears will score. A net violation was called. As you know, the net cannot be touched in any capacity. Same goes for the antenna. That will end the stint at service for Tarnowski, but not before she guided White Bear Lake to a 5-0 run. And those can be key. Back-to-back errors for the Bears. A service error and now a hitting error. Back to the service position, Sierra Pohl. From the left side, shot deflected, Matamidai taps it over. Now White Bear Lake from the right. Oh! Romali took a hard hit on the hardwood. And that will go down as a point for Adina Kloeter. I don't know if you could hear it at home or online, wherever you may be watching this, but Romali, her arm made a thunderous thud on the hardwood. Of course, a lot of high school gyms play on the hardwood courts. It changes when you get to the state tournament, and they play on those sport court surfaces at Xcel Energy Center. Longer rally developing here. Romali making the dig. But White Bear Lake will have a free ball to work with. They go to the right side. And the rally continues. Bella Thompson, she's had a few cracks at it. Block, but out of bounds. So a point off the block for Brady Keeling. 11-7, White Bear Lake over Matamidai. Service error against Stadther. The second service error unofficially for White Bear Lake, but they still have an 11-8 lead. And there are some trends developing here in this first set. I'll get to that when we have a stoppage. Bella Thompson hands the point right back to White Bear Lake as her serve goes out of bounds. First service error on Matamidai. Now we get a look at Maddie Pearson, the sophomore. White Bear Lake sends the first attack back. They should have a solid ball to play with here. And they do, as that ball, that up goes into the bleachers. Lauren Westerhaus with a rocket. White Bear Lake holding on to their advantage for now. Romali deflected. That brushed the antenna up. I saw one of the line judges wave her flag, and you could see it from our vantage point. Well, my vantage point, I should say. I don't have a camera in the announcer's booth, but I got a front row seat to that block from Matamidai. Louisa Tarnowski with the defensive play there. 13-10. Service error charge to the libero, Claire Crothers. Romali winds up, fires, but misses the mark. almost a tie-up there for the serve receive. Romali this time paints the back line. Found a spot in no woman's land. And lands what I believe is just the second kill for Matamidi in the set. Their offense hasn't put together a whole lot of rhythm yet. White Bear Lake will get a free ball out of that. We play on. White Bear Lake changing direction. And the change pays off for Kylie Gustafson, scoring her third kill unofficially in this set. White Bear Lake, by my count, 7 kills. Matamidi 2. Again, these are unofficial tallies. But White Bear Lake's offense clicking at a more efficient rate, and I believe that is making a difference in the score. That attack from Matamidi's Malvi hit the antenna before it touched a White Bear Lake player. White Bear Lake with the largest lead of this set. Matamidi answers with an off-speed hit from Malvi, making up for that miscue earlier. Molly serving White Bear Lake, feeding the hot hand in Gustafson. And that up went into the ceiling. Tough position for Matamidi to be in. And this happens at a lot of schools that have lower clearances. It's not an issue at state, but in sections for some places, and again at schools that don't have athletic centers. Matamidi, I would call a timeout as White Bear Lake up by 7. The ceiling comes into play, and if you're wondering what happens, it's still a live ball. So a hard hit that leads to a high velocity, a high altitude up, can wreak havoc depending on which side of the net it falls. As you know, 2 timeouts per set. We mentioned White Bear Lake. They placed last in the Suburban East. What will happen this year, we shall see, because there are some changes that have taken place. Eastridge, they've been the supreme chancellor of the Suburban East for the last few years now. But a lot of the pieces who got Eastridge to a state tournament run have moved on. Stillwater, they're putting together some solid numbers as well. Irondale and Forest Lake also had solid seasons, as did Roseville, all 21 teams. We'll see how 2023 shapes up. It was a year of some wild upsets, though, in 2022. There was no clear favorite in 4A as Matamidi scores on the cut, a much-needed point after the timeout for Malvi and the Zephyrs. YZ, they have been the standard bearers in 4A for the last several years, but there was a carousel of number one teams. YZ came out on top in the end. A little bit of trouble for Matamidi, and that miscommunication will cost them. Like we said, errors, mistakes, they all play a part. Gustafson serving again for White Bear Lake. Paints the line. Her second ace. If you recall, White Bear Lake went on a run the last time she was in the service position. And with the Bears holding a comfortable lead, that puts Gustafson in the driver's seat, and she has taken White Bear Lake on a trip to back-to-back aces. Another timeout for Matamidi and head coach Tia Schlund. Matamidi making state last year, but a considerably different team than what we saw a year ago. It is a reminder of the equalizer that is graduation and how that can impact teams. No matter their creed, no matter their pedigree. White Bear Lake looking to go to 3-1, which would be a solid start for them. They struggled in the conference, but as you saw in that graphic, they finished just a game under 500. They have a relatively young group themselves. They were swept by Hutchinson on Thursday. They will play St. Paul Central on Thursday, this Thursday, and Kylie Gustafson isn't playing around in the service game. Three straight aces, and White Bear Lake, I would say, has set one locked up. Gustafson, that time Matamidi able to play her serve and score on a cut. Sylvie Greitzer with the point there, but I would say Gustafson did her job again. Coaches will tell you the goal is to generate more points for your team than concede them. It's fine if you don't reel off a 5-6 point rally, but can you give your team a net positive? That line shot goes out of bounds, so a hitting error will be charged to Keeling. I believe her second. Matamidi scoring back-to-back points here. If there's time for a run, this has to come now. Not much room for error. And another shot that just missed. Kloeter was close, but not close enough. Point margin down to 7. Off speed tap works to perfection. Keeling with the point, and White Bear Lake will have 8 set points at their disposal. Stather awaiting the signal. Set point. Stather low serve and another ace closes out set number 1. Stather collects her first ace, and White Bear Lake collected 5 unofficially in the first set. They capture it 25-16 and are one step closer to reclaiming the Take the Lake surfboard. For now, we're going to surf to a break and rejoin you for set number 2 in a moment. You're watching High School Girls Volleyball on SEC Sports.
STEM is everywhere. Like here, behind the scenes of The Walking Dead.
Cut, we got it.
And for every moment like this, there's a crew of people using STEM to bring the dead to life.
We had 30 minutes to make one of Norman Reedus's outfits look 7 years old. When we break down clothes, we tumble it with trisodium phosphate, rock salt, and dish detergent.
We stitched together images of our model and created a 3D set that could be walked through in a VR headset. It looked like you were actually standing in the room.
There's so much technology involved in directing. We're able to turn 12 walkers into a 1,000 walker horde.
That idea became this design, which turned into this set, in that costume worn by that walker who was having a really bad day. STEM can create new worlds on and off the screen. What will you make with STEM? Get inspired at shecanstem.com.
White Bear Lake, one set closer to reclaiming the Take the Lake surfboard, the trophy that is awarded to the victor in the rivalry game between White Bear Lake and Matamidi. As we look at first set highlights, what stands out the most, and these are unofficial tallies, but White Bear Lake held the edge on offense, 9 kills to Matamidi's 5. Service aces, another category in White Bear Lake's favor. 5 in the first set, 4 of them coming from Kylie Gustafson, Matamidi with just the 1. So even though White Bear Lake unofficially had more hitting errors, they picked up more points through the service game and the attacking game, and that adds up when you have points on every play. Matamidi will have to find a way to create more offense consistently if they want to change the narrative. Kylie Gustafson, she was the standout player of the first set, unofficially 4 kills, 4 aces. That's a pretty good piece of work, but no one has won this game yet. You got to win 3 in this best of 5, which is always the case for regular season games. And Kylie Gustafson begins set number 2 with another kill. And I say regular season, or single game matches, if you will. Every school takes part in a number of weekend tournaments where they play a condensed 3-set affair. White Bear Lake follows up the Gustafson kill with an ace from their libero, Kaylee Giske. The Bears feasting right now offensively. Matamidi able to play this one. White Bear Lake lays off. They open set 2 with 3 straight. Off the net and down for a point. Luisa Tarnowski. Unofficially her first kill, and those net points, you never know when or where they will strike. You probably have heard the joke that if you could master them in traditional volleyball, beach volleyball, you would be making a whole lot of money. But there really is no rhyme or reason. No friendly assist from the net there needed. Kylie Gustafson dialed in. Two kills already. Allie Munyer, one of the setters. High serve and an overpass. Munyer to serve again. I believe that will go down as a serve-receive issue, and another mental mistake on the part of Matamidi. A couple of times now we've seen passes go awry. Again, a symbol of the team's youth and the learning curve as Munyer adds another ace to the tally. Matamidi will call the timeout. Yes, they made state a year ago, but only 2 starters from that team are back this year. And again, that presents a learning curve. That doesn't mean Matamidi will be an afterthought in the Metro East and beyond, but it might take them a little while to regain their form. And speaking of Metro East, here's a look at how well they did, Matamidi, that is. 25-7 overall. And undefeated in conference play. You'll notice they only had 7 conference games, some others in the same boat, but They were far and away the top team in the Metro East. It wasn't even close. Hill Murray, they were a power about 10 years ago. Simley fielded some solid teams when the Danzo sisters were students there. North St. Paul, who can forget their run back in 2019, winning bronze. And what ultimately was the last year of three-class volleyball. Monier serves that into the net. North St. Paul and that rivalry they had, the section rivalry with Stillwater, produced some memorable matches that SCC got to cover and I got to cover too. Lots of great memories. White Bear Lake. We'll want to forget that one as etching a memory on the block is number 9, Sylvie Greatzer. Montemita scoring. Back-to-back points here after trailing 7-1. Another good serve. This should give the Zephyrs a free ball, but Crothers had to dive for it to collect the up. And now that could turn the tide to White Bear Lake's favor. Gustafson off speed. Setter dump pays off for Ashley Muller. Setter dumps, one of my favorites because that is one of the more effective trick plays you can use. You only get 3 touches, of course. Makes those setter dumps, if you have a setter who can pull that off, all the more valuable. White Bear Lake using the teardrop, and Ella Stadther picks up her first kill of this set. If you're watching this on TV or at home, the big story of this game thus far, the service game. Gustafson, unfortunately, commits a service error. That's her first of this set. She had one in the first set as well, but you'll recall she had 3 straight aces in her last trip to the service position. She produces nothing there, and that could open a path of opportunity for Matamidai. You take away or neutralize one of your more effective servers. White Bear Lake was saying Matamidai touched it. The officials say no, and from my vantage point, I didn't see any deflection, so a hitting error on Lily Glendening. And it's now just a 2-point margin. It was 6 a couple minutes ago. Off speed doesn't work. Crothers gets another up on Stadther. Ramali lines one up from the left side. I can't imagine it's all that comfortable for the players in their jerseys. Several schools don't have air conditioning in the gyms. This is one of them, so it's making the indoor temperature a little warmer than you would expect for September. As we are tied at 8, I'm guessing most volleyball players and soccer and football come to mind too. Are used to that. I think during a game it's a little easier to put that aside. Cross court shot for White Bear Lake. Works out for Lily Glendening. After Matamidai tied it up, White Bear Lake retakes the lead. Hitting error on Bella Thompson. Bolted that right into the net. And as far as the conditions go, I'd say the biggest change would be bigger emphasis on staying hydrated. Did that cross the net? I don't think so. Wouldn't have mattered. There was interference anyway. Overpass and a misfire. Sylvie Greatzer I don't know if you saw the look on her face, but it went something along the lines of, oops. She knew it as soon as she released it. It happens, though. You just got to shake it off. White Bear Lake, though, they've scored four in a row. Make it five in a row. As we had a tie-up at the net, Montemite may have crossed it. And the head official is making some sort of signal. They're going to have a do-over, so it's still 12-8. The point wasn't overturned necessarily. It happens from time to time in volleyball. It's rare, but there are moments where it's unclear to the officials what happened. And that's unfortunate because it was number 12, Katie Hergenrader, who was talking with the official about the last play and meant to send that over the net. Instead, dumped it on her team's side. And so it's 13-8 anyway. Romali. That's Cloeter on the last attack. Great serve from the middle, slams it home. Again, it happens from time to time, but when it's unclear what transpired, I have seen this ruling. Officials will call a do-over and replay the point. High school games don't have the benefit of challenge systems like they do at the college level. Greatser is giving White Bear Lake a challenge along that front row. Back-to-back kills for Sylvie. ...13-10, Romali serving for Matamidai. Crothers, another up. Greatser can't operate on that front row, so White Bear Lake gets a free ball. That brushed the net before it touched Greatser, so Matamidai able to play it. White Bear Lake, though, should get another quality chance. And this time it works in their favor. Westerhaus scoring for the Bears there. White Bear Lake led 7-1. Matamidai tied it up on a 7-1 run. White Bear Lake subsequently scored five in a row. They lead 14-10 right now. Westerhaus again. Matamidai got the deflection on it, but Malvi couldn't get there in time to play it. And the Bears gaining some separation again. Leading 15-10 in set two, Westerhaus. Matamidai scoring. And now Greatser moves back to the service position. I normally point this out earlier, but when you see substitutions, I'll finish that in a moment. Greatser with the up. It's a big one, though, and nowhere to go for Matamidai. A tough second set for Hergenrader, but there's Crothers going in. When you see substitutions taking place, it isn't necessarily an indicator of a person's talent or capability. A lot of those substitutions have to do with your spot in the rotation. Matamidai with the bump set spike, and Malvi collects the kill. There's another example. So when a team goes to serve, that's when you'll typically see the rotations take place. And if there are players that maybe aren't strong in one area, the back row, for example, you'll see those frontline figures head to the bench. White Bear Lake trying to execute the setter dump. Bears lay off that time, and Mulvey will be charged with the error. Matamidi will use their first of two timeouts in set number two with White Bear Lake leading 17-12. And Matamidi in the second set, their offense a little more effective, unofficially a slight edge over White Bear Lake in kills, but errors have hampered their productivity. Five unofficially, White Bear Lake with just two in this set. A reminder of what happens and all the elements that come into play with a point on every play. As we take another look at one of our recent plays. Looking at the history, it's interesting. This rivalry was dominated by Matamidi for years. White Bear Lake picked up a regular season win 2 years ago. They meet every year, but there was a two-year layoff. They didn't meet in 2019. 2020 was the COVID year where teams only played within the conference. White Bear Lake commits the service error. And that will hand a point to Matamidi, who desperately needed it. Mulvey serving for the Zephyrs. Here's Gustafson. She fires a no-doubter. Gustafson, we don't have any numbers from these teams yet, and we're still working on getting all that information uploaded. And by that, coaches, staffers, the first couple of weeks of the season can be tricky at times for the fall sports. But Gustafson looks to me like a player to watch. Romali with a kill to watch there. Scoring again. That left side has worked to her benefit a couple of times in this set. Matamidi regained serve. It's Crothers. Gustafson on the right side, the off-speed one-handed lob falls for a point. It's not just about velocity. Finesse sometimes does the trick too. Gustafson back to serve. Let's see what happens here. That crossed the net. Ever just so, but enough for Kloeter to put it down. Gustafson, she's had four aces, but won't pick up one on that trip as she serves that into the net. Her third service error, but White Bear Lake inching closer to a second set win. Poole serving for the Zephyrs. Lob from the middle. Here's Greitzer. Zooms that past Giske for a point. Greitzer struggled to find some productivity in the first set, just one kill. She's got three unofficially here. And again, Matamidi's attacking game much stronger. Did Greitzer cross the net? No, she made contact with it. Another oops moment, and that's a tough one. She had a point easy. One of those key swings, because Matamidi would have been within three. Instead, White Bear Lake back up to a 5-point advantage. And tapping down the overpass is Westerhaus for her third kill of this set. 22-16. So far in the later stages, White Bear Lake proving to be the team that performs in the clutch, but Romali isn't ready to give this one up just yet. Looking ahead for these two, Anabidai will go to Hill Murray for a conference game on Thursday. Anabidai from the left side. Malvi's shot. Doug. Great serve. Squeezes it through that ever tight space along the wall. 22-18. White Bear Lake, they won't play their first conference game until next week against East Ridge. They have one more non-conference game, and then all of their remaining regular season games will be against Suburban East foes, weekend tournaments not being accounted for there. Hitting error on Malvi, and it's 23-18. That's typically how the Suburban East does things, since they have a larger contingent. Great serve goes behind Kurgan Raider, and that pumps Matabidai up. A different kind of hot, if you will. It's still a hot one here inside this gym, but Matabidai, for the first time in a long time, exhibiting a level of confidence. But it's still a 4-point lead for White Bear Lake. Not much room for error here. And Malvi sends that one out of bounds. So 5 set points for White Bear Lake. Brady Keeling to serve. Bears should get a free ball here, and they will. They go to the middle, Westerhaus, dug by Romali. Kurgan Raider bats over another free ball. Westerhaus won't be denied a second time. Her fourth kill of the second set, and White Bear Lake pulls away for a 25-19 victory. They are now one set away from taking the Lake Surfboard back to their campus again. We'll take a short break and find out how these sweet emotions will parlay into the third set. You're watching High School Girls Volleyball on SCC Sports.
The hard part. You quit smoking. Now do the easy part and get scanned for lung cancer. If you smoked, you may still be at risk, but early detection could save your life. Talk to your doctor and learn more at savedbythescan.org.
White Bear Lake one set away from victory in this Take the Lake rivalry game with Matamidi. You get a look at the score as of now. Second set, Matamidi, much better attacking game, 12 kills, but they committed unofficially 8 hitting errors. White Bear Lake with just 2. 25-19 score. You do the math there. White Bear Lake had 11 kills, so Matamidi with the slight edge. A pair of aces as well. Matamidi, no aces in the second set. White Bear Lake, their offense clicking a little more, but the mental miscues for Matamidi also apparent in that second set. There were a couple of passes that went offline, didn't find their target. A shot that fell on the Matamidi side. Those are things Matamidi will have to clean up, if not tonight, later on this season. Remember, this is a younger team. They graduated a lot of pieces from last year's state tournament squad in Class 3A. And that can take some doing, getting all the new pieces and instilling the lessons. Also a new coach. First year for Tia Schlunt, who has an impressive resume of her own, providing the genesis for success that Concordia St. Paul enjoyed all those years. It's White Bear Lake, though, who will enjoy a service ace from Kaylee Geske. Her second of the game. In that first set, Gustafson could do no wrong. Geske, no ace there. I thought White Bear Lake would have had a chance to play that. Couldn't quite get set in time. And Matamidi counters with Bella Thompson. So a reminder, if White Bear Lake wins, as you see, they're the W on the score bug. They win this set, that's game. If Matamidi wins, we'll play at least one more. It is best of 5. That net ball won by Gustafson. No aces for Gustafson in the second set, but she did add another 4 kills unofficially. She's up to 9 overall. Free ball coming for White Bear Lake. They go to the middle this time. That did not cross the net. A ball handling error officially on White Bear Lake. Greitzer serves that into the net. So no harm, no foul effectively for White Bear Lake in that instance. 3-2. Where White Bear Lake has proven clutch are the later stages in sets. But Gustafson, it's been feast or famine. Her first couple of trips to the service spot, nearly flawless. Her last pair of trips haven't produced as many positives. From the middle, look out. Not much that Muller could do. Stadther with the laser. And I say look out because our broadcast booth is right up in front of the action. Muller with the bump. Rivali displeased with herself. Wanted that one back. That serve just skirted the net. And that attack skirted the net, but it lands for Malvi nonetheless. Thank you. Molly to serve. Off speed hit by Keeling. White Bear Lake will score on the double contact. Those calls, I've given credit to volleyball officials over the years because you have to have sharp vision and precision. And how quick things move in this sport. Like Malvi on that cut. Her second kill of this set. On my way in, there were a lot of first day of school processionaries going on. Some schools, the private schools began last week, but most of the public schools beginning their new school year today. That will be a hitting error on Westerhaus. And for those who have kids, you know it, it's the year where your social media channels are inundated with first day of school photos. For those who have school-age kids and for those who don't and have a sense of humor about things, like me, it was the first day of 31st grade. And Brady Keeling, probably not thinking about that right now, but her shot, even though it didn't land for a kill right away, put Matamidi in a bind, and White Bear Lake gets the point nonetheless. Now Keeling serving. Greatzer had to hesitate for a minute. Gustafson with the off-speed tap. And Allie Munyer, we haven't called her name a lot, doing a solid job as the setter. I feel like setters are akin to linemen in football. We don't mention their names as often because they don't lead the offense, but they play an integral role in it. That painted the line. Matamidi thought it was going out, and a look of surprise on Westerhaus. She wasn't sure that was going to stay in. In fact, when I glanced at her facial expressions, I think she thought it was going out too. But I don't think she'll complain about that point. White Bear Lake leading 9-6. They've looked pretty solid so far, but a miscue there on the part of Keeling results in a service error. And by the time you watch this, for most of you anyway, the conditions will be more seasonal, which will mean future volleyball games will be a little more pleasant. Hitting error on Bella Thompson. You could argue that White Bear Lake is finding this game pretty pleasant. Everyone has their stories of grit, tales of grit, if you will, as I had to keep an eye on that one. Sather thought she hit it too hard, or it looked that way, but it was touched. So it will be a kill instead. And another serve coming for Kaylee Giske. White Bear Lake making their move a little earlier than usual. Great serve making a move. Her shot was dug by Pearson, and that allows White Bear Lake to score again. Kylie Gustafson. Her service game has tapered off, but her attacking prowess remains on point as White Bear Lake leads 12-7. We are back here, not here specifically, but we'll be back on Friday for more SEC sports coverage. In fact, here's a look at our schedule. Throughout the month of September, White Bear Lake and Mounds View will battle it out in football, so I guess we are back here at this facility. And then Tartan Matabidi, Metro East doubleheader on September 11th, 1 week from today. More football at Tartan as they host Bloomington Jefferson. And we'll be back here September 27th for White Bear Lake and Woodbury Volleyball, a Suburban East Conference battle that you can see. All games can be seen on SCC. Here's a look at the last point for White Bear Lake. Gustafson performing well, and she has throughout the evening. The service game, you'd like to be as productive as you can, but if that's not possible, maintain your consistency in the hitting game, and good results will follow. Sylvie Greatzer sends that hit out of bounds. And White Bear Lake gaining more ground. Oregon Raider to Tarnowski, and she hits that into the net. Now what you're looking for coming out of a timeout, giving up 2 points on errors. Low serve, Matabidi unable to do anything with it. Kaylee Giske using that finesse, that touch that we've talked about, to full effect. Giske hasn't rattled off a string of aces like Gustafson did, but she's been responsible for a few points from that spot. Sends another low one. Back-to-back points. Giske with the reverse announcer's jinx, if you believe in that sort of thing. Matabidi has to burn their final timeout of this set, so they'll be out of timeouts the rest of the way. Depending on what happens, we'll see how that impacts the game, but it's White Bear Lake thriving, scoring four in a row after that first timeout. And Giske a big part of that. Giske, a sophomore. We talked about the youth. Matabidi, they like the depth they have in their program, in their roster, and that could come into play over time, whether it's later this season or in future seasons. But White Bear Lake, they don't have a lot of seniors either. Here's a look at Matabidi's upcoming schedule. Again, they have that conference battle with Hill Murray. They'll play another Suburban East foe in Park of Cottage Grove. Orno on September 19th. And St. Anthony Village, some of the non-conference games. The Metro East a little smaller in girls sports. The conference could be up for grabs this year. Matabidi won it running away last year. There have been shifts over the years. Hill Murray, then North St. Paul, and that will be a point for Matabidi. White Bear Lake made contact with the net. And if there is a time for Matabidi to accrue a point, that was it. They'd like to add a few more in succession. They will, on the hitting error by Larissa Komarek. Matabidi, they have their work cut out for them. As they try to chip away, but Bella Thompson's service error isn't going to help the cause. 17-9, a reminder that Matabidi is out of timeouts. White Bear Lake has one more non-conference game. It's against St. Paul Central, and then after that, they'll move into the Suburban East. And we'll see how they fared this year. Just one conference win, they'd like to change it. Gustafson looked to go cross court. Missed the corner, though. Or did she? Net violation, that's what it was. Greitzer touched the net, so that's a point for White Bear Lake, and that's another one as Greitzer hits that shot into the net. So a couple points ago, Greitzer touched the net before Gustafson's shot went out of bounds. And that's how White Bear Lake scored. Service error on the Bears, but they have plenty of room to work with as they look to make this a straight set victory. Matamidi lays off, and it pays off. ...19-11 as Cloeter's off-speed lob sailed past the boundary. Gustafson, that was dug, but White Bear Lake gets a free ball here. Cloeter again. This time gets the off-speed lob to drop. What's the old saying? If at first you don't succeed, 2011. Matamidi, they can't do anything more to stop this run, already out of timeouts. We mentioned the third set has been very good to White Bear Lake in the early going this season. Another passing error for Matamidi. For Katie Hergenrader and the others, I suspect that will be a point of emphasis the next time they hold a practice session. And again, volleyball, it's about an eight-week season, and you have the weekend tournament, so a lot of chances. As Matamidi scores there, Brooke Bauer with the off-speed lob. I'm sure Matamidi and the contingent that's here, they would love to start things off the way they did a year ago en route to a section championship. Bauer collecting the block there. But sometimes that process is gradual. And you endure a lot of bumps and lumps and turbulence along the way. You go through stretches where you just want to take whatever happened and throw it out the window. Romali throws down a point. Matamidi, they've had brushes of success where they're able to construct a few rallies. It could be the building block for this young team. Again, not a lot of experience from last year's team. New head coach. It could take time to gel. Free ball for the Bears. Cloeter. Did not cross. More specifically, her shot did not cross the net. 21-15. Matamidi. Are we seeing a push from them? Crothers with the up. Romali, one-handed tap. Free ball for the Zephyrs. Romali couldn't do much with it, though. Tough set there. Set her dump. Giske reads it. Another hitting error, and now it's a five-point margin. White Bear Lake, I was sensing they would call the timeout soon, and from the looks of it, Gustafson, their anchor on offense, hasn't been much of a factor over these last few points. Matamidi out of timeouts, but they've got momentum on their side for the moment. As long as you can keep a team from reaching 25, you still have a chance. That is the unpredictability of untimed sports. Some pride on the line, of course. Here's a look at White Bear Lake's upcoming schedule. Like we said, one more non-conference game, and then they will move into the Suburban East portion of their season, weekend tournaments notwithstanding. St. Paul Central should be a winnable game. And each team plays each other once in conference play. We'll have to see how things shake out. Eastridge, they've set the standard for a while. And you may recall their big upset over Egan, a team that was one of the perennials. Matamidi closes within four. White Bear Lake, by the way, has one more timeout. It's Malvi who scores the kill. And White Bear Lake's offense had stalled. Gustafson is out there for the Bears on the rotation. Shot in the net. Keeling is struggling. The margin is three. It looked like White Bear Lake was going to cruise to a potential straight set victory. There was a stumble on White Bear Lake's part, but the serve from Ashley Moeller was just outside. I was going to say, remember, Matamidi had a reverse sweep to earn their first win of the season over Highland Park. But back-to-back errors won't help the cause. Malvi taps that outside the barrier. And now White Bear Lake sits 2 points away from victory. Another miscue on the part of Matamidi. Ashley Moeller tried to connect with Brooke Bauer, but the pass was too soft. White Bear Lake with six match points. Romali keeps Matamidi in the game for the moment. Romali seemed to settle in after that first set. She might be a player to watch later this season and beyond. She goes back to serve here. No room for error now if you're Matamidi. White Bear Lake finishes the job. Lauren Westerhaus off the set from Munyer. Westerhaus just her second kill of this set, but she had a productive night overall. Seven unofficially overall, and it's a straight set sweep for White Bear Lake, although they had to work a little harder than perhaps they thought in set number three. 25-16, 25-19, 25-19, and props to Kylie Gustafson. A terrific start, four aces in that first set, five overall, and a good number of kills as well. 11 unofficially. The surfboard is coming back to White Bear Lake, and for the third straight year, the home team winning the trophy. White Bear Lake and Matamidi had split the first two, so that trophy case at White Bear Lake will have to hold a spot for that surfboard. Tomorrow might be a little cooler, but I'd say the weather tonight would be a great time to use it if you can avoid the rains. But White Bear Lake goes to 3-1. Matamidi falls to 1-3. And White Bear Lake hoping to ride this wave of momentum into Suburban East Conference play. A younger group, but a considerable amount of potential as well. So that will do it here from White Bear Lake. In the Take the Lake rivalry game, it goes to White Bear Lake. on a straight set win, 25-16, 25-19, 25-19. We're back here at White Bear Lake on Friday for high school football. So until then, for the rest of our SCC crew, this is Mike Peden reminding you to help control the pet population. Have your pets spayed or neutered. Goodbye, everybody.